So we're going to do another example of defining a recursive procedure. And the goal this time is to take in a string and determine whether or not it's a palindrome. What a palindrome is a string that reads the same way, forwards and backwards. So an example of a palindrome would be level. If we read level forwards, we get level. If we read it backwards, we get exactly the same thing. Another example of a palindrome would be the word, the single letter A. If we read A forwards, we get A. If we read A backwards, we also get A. In fact, any single letter must be a palindrome. The empty string is also a palindrome. If we read the empty string forward, we have the empty string. If we read the empty string backward, we also have the empty string. So our goal is to define a procedure that will take any string as input and output true if that string is a palindrome. I'm going to give you a few hints how to do this, but start thinking on your own if you can think of a way to define a procedure that tests whether or not a string is a palindrome. So this is a pretty tough question. See how far you can get on your own, but I'm going to provide some hints before we make the quiz. So the first hint is we want to think of what it means to be a palindrome to try to formalize that definition. If we knew easy ways to produce the reverse of the string and check if it's equal, well, that would be an easy way to solve this. And in fact, there are ways to do that in Python, but we haven't seen them yet. And I want to have you think about ways to do is palindrome that don't depend on that. So that means we need to think about a way of defining is palindrome in terms of simpler things. So the first thing to notice is there's one simple case where we know right away whether a string is a palindrome. So we should think that that might be our base case. When we do procedures on numbers, our base case is often something that deals with a number like 0 or 1, a small number. When we do recursive procedures on strings, it's more likely that our base case is going to be the simpler string, which is the empty string. So we know that if the input is the empty string, the result of is palindrome is true. The empty string is a palindrome. What if the input's not an empty string? Well, then one way to solve that would be to look at the first letter of the string and look at the last letter of the string. If those two are equal, well, then it might be a palindrome. It's a palindrome if all the ones left over in the middle are also a palindrome. So this is how we could break the question of testing whether a string's a palindrome into smaller steps, that our recursive case is going to test the first and the last character of the string, see if those are equal. So for our recursive case, we're going to test the first and the last characters of the string. If those don't match, we know it's not a palindrome. That means we know the result is false. If they do match, we're not done. We need to check the rest of the string. And that means we need to check the middle of the string if that's a palindrome. And because we're able to define this recursively, remember that we're defining the procedure is palindrome, but we can do this test assuming that we've already defined it. In order to check whether the middle of the string is a palindrome, we can use the procedure that we're defining. This is like we were able to use factorial to define factorial in terms of a smaller number. In this case, we're defining palindrome in terms of a smaller string. So I hope this is enough for you to get started. So see if you can define the code for is palindrome, keeping in mind that we can break it down into these two cases, where if it's empty, we know it's a palindrome right away. If it's not empty, well, we need to look at that first and last characters. If they do match, we also need to look at the middle of the string.